Hello, ladies and gentlemen, fellow traders. Welcome to our BBMA trade review for the week of 14 to 18 of July 2020. Let's get started. Here is our trade for the week of 14 to 18 of July. Our growth of minus 0.59%. We have EU, AU, NU, stop out. GJ we carry for this week. We have no entry on gold, CHF, and GN we close TP. Okay, let's look at the trade. Start by looking at the Euro USD trade. We mark the last week candle. This is the last week candle. When we walk to the chart, this is what we saw. We saw that the price is at the sell zone, which is the MA510 high on the weekly time frame. And then when we go to the lower time frame, then we go for daily. In daily, we can see that the price is also at the re-entry sell zone. However, if we look for last week candle, which is, we're supposed to be here. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is where it's supposed to be for last week. As you can see, we don't have any daily engulfing sell for Euro USD. So this is definitely not a good trade to take, but somehow we make a mistake and take the trade. Reason being because, as you can see here, I put this arrow here. This was the candle that we saw last week. So we think that the trade was good because we have the engulfing candle there. However, on a daily time frame, as you can see again on daily, we don't have any engulfing candle for the past week from here to here. We don't have any engulfing candle. So that's why the setup was not good. In fact, on the daily time frame, the price is keep making a higher low. So we enter the trade and we stop out. Okay. For next one, we want to check the AUD-USD. AUD-USD, let's look at AUD-USD from weekly. Last week, hold on, let the chart load. Last week, this is what we saw on AUD-USD. Price is here. Okay, basically, this is the open of last week, and actually we saw something like that, right? The last candle is not there, so what we see is this small candle. So if you look at daily time frame, on daily time frame, price is actually making a very tight range, and it is the same thing. However, on AUD USD, remember seeing the trade was at profit at certain on like Wednesday, because this candle moving down. As you can see here, this is the inside bar. This one, this is on this what we see on Monday, and actually we see a inside bar here. This is the mother candle. Okay. However, this mother candle was broken on Wednesday. Which actually give us some profit on this candle. So price actually go all the way down, and if we can see on a weekly time frame, price almost approached the MA510 low. Okay. However, we did not take the profit, and then the price retest and hit our stop loss. So this could be a profitable trade if we manage the trade well, but we did not break even the trade when it was profiting for last week, as you can see here at this candle. And if we move to H4, on H4, if we can see here, after the trade was triggered, right, we have a bearish engulfing here. The price actually reject the low BB here. Let me mark it, this area. So we see a rejection here, and at the same time, as you can see here, we have a bullish engulfing showing the price gonna continue to go up. So we're supposed to close our trade here with minimum profit at this around this level, but we did not manage the trade well. So if we close around here, we could we should be at least break even or minimal loss or minimal profit, sorry. Okay, that's for AUD USD. For AUD USD, the issue was mainly on trade management. And next trade is NZD USD. Let's look at NZD USD. NZD USD. Okay, we start with the weekly time frame. See what we first saw when we come to the chart for last week. Okay, last week what we saw was this last bullish candle. As you can see here, this is a re-entry sell zone. Then we move to daily time frame. And we want to see if there is a bearish engulfing or not. Yes, there is a bearish engulfing here. actually, this would have been a good trade if we close it on Tuesday. Okay, on Tuesday. It was profiting. I remember saying it was on a profit, but I did not set it to be as well. And then the same thing. The same thing. Sorry, supposed to go to H4. Okay, you can see here our trade triggered here. It take almost all of our entries, and then it make a momentum. Okay, when this momentum happen, right? We have two options: to close the trade or set it to break even. But I did not do that for the last week. And then when this candle come, we've seen a bullish engulfing. Okay. Let me mark it with arrow so it's clear. So we should have closed the trade at when this candle appear. As you can see here, using the basic BBMA setup, this is a extreme, right? Extreme buy. So when extreme buy happen, price will of course go up. So this trade we should close around this level. We can close here or here, because this is the first time we can close the first time momentum happen and set it to break even, so we don't have we secure our profit and let the runner run. This is where we're supposed to take our first profit and break even the trade. So should have do that, we could have we can exit at minimum loss or minimum profit, right? BE. And when this pattern happened, we should have closed the trade, all of the trade here, which give us quite a decent profit because we have all the entry from this level up here. I remember, okay, we have all this entry. Okay, so that's for NZD USD. Again, it's more on trade management because last week was a busy week. I did not look at the chart very actively. Okay, for GJ is still running. GJ, we start from weekly time frame. I have an old trade on GJ on this account. Okay, GJ last week was we seeing this candle. It's a MA510 high, which is a sell. And then as we go to daily has a good follow through, as you can see here. That's why GJ we're still in profit now. I'm holding the trade. Okay, we break this mother candle. Okay, that's not the mother candle, this is the mother candle, this one. Okay, and we have a nicely developed reversal pattern here. And price keep moving down on, this is Friday, Thursday, so this is Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. So on Tuesday, price really went down all the way to this level. Okay, so let's look at H4. We have opportunity to close the trade at a bigger profit, but we did not close it. So I think on Monday, I will close the trade, although it's in profit, or I will choose to break even the trade to let the profit run if the price continue to go down. Okay, so that's for GJ. And then gold. We want to sell gold. Okay. However, gold was not making a downtrend for the last few weeks. Okay. Sorry, the gold chart was really nasty here. Okay. Here we are. This was the candle we saw last week. It's a sell, MHV sell basically, but we take it as a re-entry sell. So we're looking to sell the whole week. And then we go to D1. Okay, on D1, we can see here, this is Monday, Tuesday, price is going up. See, it doesn't break this mother candle. It go up, go up, go up. And then it making a bearish engulfing here. Okay, however, this bearish engulfing does not break this mother candle. So, and also it was Thursday. So usually I'll try not to take the trade on Thursday, although I see the signal. Okay, so that's it for gold. And then on, as you can see on H4 did not make any moment sell, I mean CSM as well, sell momentum sell. So gold we do not enter any trade. All right. Next pair is CAD CHEF. Okay. Let's wait a moment for the chart to load. For CAD CHEF, let's look at the weekly. Okay. CAD CHEF. Wait a moment. The chart is still loading. Okay, so basically this, alright. Let's go for that. Okay, last week we see CAD CHEF at the sell zone, buy zone, which is down here. Okay, and we go to the this week candles on daily. Okay, on daily there is a there's a bullish, big bullish engulfing here. However, this bullish engulfing is not very good because it's reached all the way up to the to the sell zone on daily. Okay, and on H4, yeah, on H4 there's a CSM. Okay, however, I was waiting for this CSM and somehow I missed the signal. So this would have been a valid trade, however I did not enter it for last week. And as you can see here, price is retesting the zone. Basically, for this trade, we'll still be able to enter because let's get back to daily. Move to daily time frame. This is Thursday, Friday, Thursday, Wednesday, Tuesday, Monday. So okay, we mark our, let's mark our entry zone for last week. So our entry zone was from here to here. Okay, should we have entered, it already stop out, so our entry zone should be from here. When this candle happen, we take it from mid BB to the low BB. Sorry. Enter here. So if we if you have entered the trade, we have a few position running. Of course it's a negative floating at this moment of time, but somehow I missed the signal for CADGSF, so I did not have any entry on CADGSF. Okay, last pay just now was GN. GN, so I don't have GN in the list here. How do I wait a minute. Okay, so we will review GN later, but for now that's all we have for this.